to show you how to take melting points today of organic substances. There are a few things that you need as far as the equipment is concerned. So you will need a melt temp apparatus, you will need a thermometer, you will need a sample, and you will need a weighing paper or filter paper. You will need a spatula, and then you will also need a capillary, which is called a melting point capillary because it's closed on one side and it's open on the other side. Okay, and so you'll put your sample through here, and this is the closed-ended side. Okay, so these are the things that you need for your melting point determination. Okay, so the way to start this process is to take a little bit of the sample and place that on the paper. You need a very little bit of the sample. You don't take too much of it, otherwise it will be all wasted. Or you'll have to throw it away. So don't take too much of it. Then you will also have to grind it into fine powder because you need to get it inside the capillary. So the best way to do that is to turn the piece of paper on itself and then use your spatula to kind of crush the sample. Once you think you've crushed it enough, then you can open it up. Now be careful, because since this is a paper, it will jump out at you. So best is to keep the paper like this and keep the spatula like this, all right, in order to hold the paper down. Then you will get your melting point capillary and again take the open-ended side, okay, and then stand it upside down, open-ended down, and try to get a little bit of sample in there. And you can see the sample, okay, that's on the end here now, and tap it down gently. Okay, and don't try not to spill it too much, but tap it down gently, and you can see the sample going down then. And what you will do then is tap it gently on the table as well. Okay, and so this does two things. This tapping does two things. First of all, it will bring all your sample down, and you can see how much sample you added on there. And the second thing it does for you is it packs the sample very well, okay? Because you need to pack the sample. If it is all distributed, you will not get a very accurate melting point. So you want it to be packed. So this one needs a little bit more sample, so I'll go ahead and get some more in there. And do exactly the same thing, which means tap it down gently and then tap it against the bench. Okay, do this gently so you don't break the capillary and don't hurt yourself while you're doing this. Okay, so this is the amount of sample that you will need in there, and you can see it's about 1 to 2 millimeters in height. Okay, that's about all you need. If you take too much of it, you'll have a hard time seeing the ending and the starting point because it will be a large range. You don't want that. And if it's too small, it will melt too quickly and you will not get an accurate range. So you want about this much of the sample in there. Now to get your melt temp apparatus set up, what you'll have to do is plug it in, of course. And this is the on button for it. This is the on switch. Right here is the heating control. Okay, so you can control the heating rate from 0 to 10, but you want to keep the heating rate to about 3 or 4. Okay, most of the organic compounds will melt below 300, so you don't want it to be a very high heating rate. You want to actually observe the melting point. So you want to keep the heating rate to about 3 or 4. There is a spot for a thermometer, okay, in your thermometer apparatus. So the thermometer goes right in here. And if you look closely over here, you will see that the light turned on when I turned the apparatus off. Okay, so here it is again. You'll see the light on, and you will also see that there is a magnifying glass in there. Okay, and the magnifying glass is actually right in front of where your sample is going to be. So now I'm going to go ahead and place the sample inside so you can see how to place the sample. There are three slots in there for sample, and you can place it in any one of them. Okay, and so here's the sample. You can place it in any one of them, and you should be able to see that clearly. Okay, and so now looking through the magnifying glass, you should be able to tell when it started melting, which means it'll be a liquid, and then when it's completely melted, it will be a complete liquid at that point. So then all you have to do is watch for the thermometer, okay, over here, and read the thermometer as you're getting the melting done. So that's about it. Keep the heating rate to about 3 or 4. And if you're taking multiple melting points, okay, so I mean at the same time you can do about 3 samples in here, but if you're doing multiple melting points and you want to do it again, then make sure that the instrument will cool down to about 30 or 40 degrees Celsius before you start over again, okay? And then once you're done with the melting point, take out the capillary that goes in the glass waste and you can turn off the apparatus.